Hi, and welcome to this quick Sonic tech tip. We're going to be looking at how to set up a vocoder in Ableton. I've got a blank page here, and the vocoder I'm going to be using is the TAL vocoder, and this is a free vocoder you can download off the internet, and we'll post the links. A vocoder works by combining two sounds, a carrier and a modulator, and it takes the common frequencies of the two sounds and melds them together and spits out a sound. And this is what we're going to be working with. We're going to combine a vocal with a synth sound, which is pretty common. So we're going to make two tracks. We're going to make an audio track. It's going to be our modulator with our vocal on it. We're going to create a MIDI track, which is going to be our synth. And this is called the carrier. And I'll just load our vocal sample. Unfortunately, it's another one of me saying stuff down a microphone. This is the sample.
Oh yeah, Sonic Academy is so amazing. I learn loads of things that are really cool and I make really good tunes. Oh.
So that's the that's the vocal we're going to be using. And I'm going to load in the silent into the carrier, and we'll create an initialized preset, and I have a MIDI part here that I'm gonna use for it as well. We'll solo this and let you hear it. Okay, so we're going to combine that MIDI part with this vocal modulation. And we do that by setting our input mode on our vocoder to left as carrier and right as modulator. And then we assign our carrier to the left, which is our synth, and to our right we assign our modulator, which is our vocal. And then we have to send the audio from these two channels into our vocoder. So we go audio to vocoder, audio to vocoder. And now, with some luck, we should have a bit of vocoding. Okay, so that's working. There's a few things we can do to make this sound a good bit better. One of them is turning up the release a bit on the synth so it sort of patches the gap between any notes. And we're also going to put it into mono legato mode, solo, and turn the portamento up a bit. And this just means it's going to sweep up between notes in pitch as opposed to just jumping, so it sounds a bit more natural. And one of the other things we can do is we've got a couple of controls here in the vocoder. We've got our harmonics. Just basically makes it easier to understand what the vocal's saying, so handy. We've also got a smudge. So that's sort of just like a release time type thing. So again, when it's quite low, it's easier to sort of make out what the vocal's saying. And the last thing we've got on our vocoder is this chorus. Because obviously if the carrier and modulator are both mono signals, the only output that the vocoder can give you is a mono signal. And this chorus just helps to give a bit of stereo width. And it works pretty well. It's quite a nice sound off it. So there you go. There's our quick tech tip for the week. How to set up a vocoder in Ableton.